Can you try and get Dianne on the phone? Misha from the text line, it says, this is Dianne. I have a confession. I've been trying to live a clean life, and I fell off the wagon.
Oh, no, Dianne.
I had more sex this weekend than I've had in 2 years.
Whoa!
Get Dianne on the phone.
Call Dianne. Getting Dianne on the phone. It's time to talk to Dianne. She texts in. You can do the same, 410-338-1098. We'd love to talk to you, but we really want to talk to Dianne.
Oh, yeah, right there. Oh,
oh, yeah. Oh man. Damn.
Another texter says, two of my coworkers and I got trashed last night, and we're now regretting it this morning.
Yeah, I can imagine. Damn, these are Monday morning confessions still flying in.
Still flying in.
Oh, hell yeah. Damn, Dianne. So was she like a, is she coming across as a sex addict?
She said she was trying to live a clean life. I don't know. I guess, well, free from,
let's find
sex?
Out straight from the horse's mouth herself.
Hi, guys.
We got Dianne. Dianne, good morning, Dianne.
Shout out.
Good morning.
Hi.
All right, let's break down this text, Dianne. I've been trying to live a clean life. What does that mean?
My religion, the religion that I grew up in, I've been trying to get closer to God.
Same.
And so for the last 2-3 years, I've been abstinent.
Uh-huh.
And a prior partner that I had kind of parted ways with has kind of come back.
Oh, yeah. Okay. A former lover.
You're both super hard up for sex.
Yeah, he was sick for a long time. He wasn't sure that he was going to make it. And now
Jesus.
He's kind of bounced back in a big way.
Damn,
big way.
And he bounced right into that bed, didn't he?
Hell yeah, he did.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Hey, how'd that abstinence work out for
time,
you?
Yeah, how was abstinence, by the way?
Abstinence work out for you? Is that a thing? Like, did you get closer to God? Was God like, hey, Dianne, good job.
Not getting any wean. Yeah, things were really going good for me right now. I mean, I was in a bad way for a long time. I was in a dark place for a long time and abstinent for 2 years, and my life really turned around.
Okay. All right, that's good. So, but still, so you began to feel the throb, the crave.
Oh, it's always been there.
Oh, okay. Never went away. Hell yeah.
No.
So you were just taking care of business on your own, you know, obviously having fun with yourself. But there was something about why weren't you having sex?
Like I said, I was just trying to like purify, you know, just
cleanse.
Trying to get closer to God. Yeah, just cleansing. It was a lot of I have relationship issues. I said bad.
Yep. Okay.
All right.
Like
so you went through a penis detox. So this former lover, they kind of float into your life. Who makes the first move on who? Because you both seem to be kind of hard up in your own way. Who fires the first shot?
Oh, he did.
Hell yeah.
Walk us through the...
Yeah, he chased me for a while.
So he chased you, and then you guys finally meet up this weekend?
I'd been going up to see him for like 2 months, but I still kind of tried to push him away.
Right.
You know, still trying to keep it clean, but... His birthday was yesterday.
So his birthday was yesterday. Is that what you said?
Oh.
Yeah, my birthday's tomorrow. So we kind of had a birthday blowout weekend.
Oh, I bet you did. Blew out the old ham candle.
Walk us through the first moments of intimacy. Where were you? What day was it? Where were you?
How much was the hotel?
Well, it wasn't a hotel. He has his own place. He lives up in Pennsylvania.
So you went up to PA.
Mm-hmm.
You know you're horny when you're crossing state lines.
Yeah, hell yeah.
When you're crossing state lines.
State line, baby.
Woo!
So you go up there. He's got his own house. How's it go down? Because you're both so pent up at this point.
Oh, yeah. well, I don't want to get dumped again. So.
Oh, this is Dianne.
Keep it clean.
Oh, I know, Dianne. This is big heart Dianne. Okay, yeah. Don't do what you did that made you kind of a folk hero. Okay. So you show up.
Is it what day do you go up to Pennsylvania? What day?
Saturday afternoon.
So you get up there Saturday afternoon. You show up at his house. What do you go out for? A couple of drinks, some dinner, or do you just get right to it?
No, we got right to it.
Hell yeah. Really?
Right to it.
Yeah, his birthday present, you know.
You just went backwards. Let me ask you this.
How horny were you driving up there? Like, you must have been so, like, anticipatory, like, horniness.
I'm still trying to stay pure. Trying not to go full on. But, yeah, once you get into it, once you get started, it kind of all comes flooding back.
Were you speeding? Were you just hauling ass the whole way?
No. There were a lot of police officers, so I kept on the cruise control, so I didn't get any trouble.
How long after you arrived at the house to the moment where you're just in the throes of passion? Was it 10 minutes, 20 minutes, half hour, hour?
I think we lasted about an hour.
And then you were finally just like, screw it?
Yeah. He was like, okay, well, come on.
Okay, come on. Hell yeah. Did he reach out and take you upstairs, or was it right there on the couch?
No, we went back to his bedroom. And
nice. Good for you.
Was there music, candles, or was it real, like, naughty America?
Naughty.
Oh, just in case. Yeah, we're going to dump Diane a second time.
So Saturday afternoon, and then you drive back, what, Sunday night? So you had, like, let's say a day and a half?
Yeah.
How many times?
Three.
Whoa. Gotcha. Yeah, good for you, Diane. The old slump buster.
And listen.